Here in the courtyard of Malak Al Hospital in southern Sudan, the question of independence from the north is on everyone's lips. These women, however, are here for an entirely different emergency. Sagena Wale is here with her son, who has Kala Azar, the Sudanese name for leishmaniasis.
I realized my child was sick because every night he had a fever and vomited. We took him to the hospital at Adon. From there he was referred to Malak Al, where they found out he had Kala Azar.
Visceral leishmaniasis is endemic in southern Sudan. This year, however, the region is suffering its worst epidemic in 8 years. The disease is transmitted to humans by sandflies carrying the parasite.
Patients have severe anemia, they have fevers, weakness, malnourished, and become ill quite quickly after exposure to it. In terms of treatment, if people do not seek treatment, in about 95 to 98% of cases, it is fatal.
Yet a treatment that is effective in 95% of cases does exist. Ambisone is given to patients intravenously. But in this region devastated by insecurity and population displacement, most people don't even have access to basic health care.
One of the things that we see happening is that patients come very late because this is such a major journey for them to take. So people are reluctant to come and they stay home for a long period of time, and then by the time they get to us, they are so weak that it's very difficult to treat them successfully.
By the end of November 2010, Médecins Sans Frontières had treated 2,355 patients with Kala Azar in southern Sudan, 8 times more than at the same time the previous year. This health crisis is affecting a region already hard hit by other epidemics, as well as chronic malnutrition.